site. We have QA offices also in Prague. We just moved to new offices here in Karlin like 1 month ago. And because we have a lot of space here, we are of course searching for new colleagues. So, with the advertisement, so we don't need to feel so lonely here. Okay, so hello again. Thanks for the introduction, and I would like to tell you something about how we developed our chatbot solution. And before I start, I would like to warn you that the title of the presentation should be actually something like how we failed. So just let me start with a brief recap of ChatBot.com. You already know that we are travel agencies and some flight tickets. Maybe you might not know that pretty much half of the company is working in the customer service department. We have more than 1,500 people. So, and 10% of them are working on chat online support, which is a part we focus on with our chatbot solution. So you might be asking right now yourself, why do we need so many people? It's like a company Sirius from Hitchhiker Guide to Galaxy, which was spread across several planets. And the thing is that usually everything works quite fine. You travel from place A to B. But if something bad happens, it usually quite sucks. And you need help. And if you are stuck in an unknown environment, you might be the only possible people for you that might help with your issue. And because we want to be able to sell you the tickets next time, we can't fail you, basically. So, very quickly we realized that we cannot take a common approach and just replace some people with some artificial intelligence, because that solution would need to work on 100%, and that's something which is not simply possible. You can predict all the possible messages you can receive from your customers. This is just an example. You have some assumption that your customer will respond by booking ID, but surprisingly, he doesn't know anything about booking ID. And if you don't expect some sentence, your chatbot just fails and doesn't know how to respond. So how it works in our case? In our schema, agent is still important for us. People are still important. They have some abilities that are hard to achieve for machines. They have emotions, they can recognize how the people are feeling right now. So we decided that instead of replacing the people, we will just suggest possible sentences for the agent, and agent just can click on it and send it right back to the customer. This actually save a lot of time, because a lot of requests that are coming are quite repetitive, and messages that they needed to write were very often quite similar to each other. So what's behind from a technical perspective? I would like to mention that from my perspective, decision tree simply is not the answer, because as I just mentioned, you can predict all possibilities. So if you try to play with some current chatbots that were announced, you usually can break them just in 1, 2, 3 steps at most. For example, this is one Czech company that is selling some equipment for coffee. So, because I'm a coffee hipster as well, I decided I want to try it and buy some stuff to do it, and it immediately failed, because I didn't know what does it mean, big or small. I just wanted to buy my mocha pot, and it didn't work well. So instead of that, we definitely need some natural language processing, and instead of implementing some our own model and basically re-implementing the wheel, we decided to go with a tool that is called Dialog Flow. Just a quick question: how many of you know this tool? Okay, not much. Yeah, this is probably one of the most easiest way how to start with such things. If you want to try to develop your own chatbot, I can definitely recommend you to look on it. So instead of following some part, deciding whether it's B or A, and go to the wall pair, it works in a way that at first you need to detect intent of the conversation. That's, for example, adding the baggage to the booking, or refund, or canceling the booking. After you detect this intent, you need to fill the slots, which means you need to receive from the customer all necessary information that is related to the intent. For example, booking ID, his name, email, etc. After you have all the necessary information, you proceed with the final action. So that's how the dialogue works, and this is how our flow looks like as a whole. So we have agents with a browser. We which contains the Chrome extension, which suggests all the things to agents, and it communicates with our service that is developed using the serverless technology, and that's deployed in Amazon, and it communicates with Dialogflow and the state of the conversation is managed by DynamoDB. And inside of the Lambda function, which is running on Amazon, we have this architecture. When we receive the new message, we take also the previous state of the conversation. We dispatch some action, which means calling the API, receiving the response from the dialog flow, and processing that response. If we match some intent, we have some information what it's about, we send back the suggestions, and after that we store all the data or the state back to the DynamoDB. And it may remind you one thing, and it's basically working just like Redux. If just a quick question, how many of you are JavaScript developers here? Yeah. Okay, so some of you. So as you can see, we use pretty much the front-end architecture on backend side in our Lambda function, and it works quite fine. So the final result, well, we found out that it's not used by our agents as much as we expected. And there are reasons. It's not, they don't start using it automatically for several reasons, and this is just an example of them. The thing is that early agent has, for example, his own taste, what he's used to write, and if this agent is not identifying himself with the content of the suggestion, he simply decides to not use it and write it again as he was used to. And so this is still some challenges we are now facing, and we are right now trying to improve this approach. And also we found that they lack more basic needs, and they spend a lot of time searching in various internal systems. So we also decided that that's something we can help with. And not right now, we are able not to just suggest the message, but also show the booking information that is related to the content of the conversation.
So the result looks something like this. We edit the right panel, which is shown on the right side. And that's what they can use. And the green one is suggestion. And yeah. So based on some numbers, it seems we saved some time. Because we have so many people, it's quite a huge amount of time. And also the number of messages that are coming from the extension is slowly increasing. And yeah, so in the end, I would like to point out one thing. In our perspective, currently chatbots are not mainly about replacing people by some artificial intelligence, but it's more about cooperation between people and system. So if you are interested, look on these two links where you can find more about how to develop a chatbot and how it's all working. And that's all. Thank you for your attention. And if you are still interested, as I mentioned in the beginning, we have, as a code.kiwi.com, we have offices in Prague as well.